Good day everyone, this is Engineer Algin Michael G. Sabak and I welcome you to another discussion about Earth science. Last time we have discussed the four main branches of Earth science and now we will deal with its branches. Today, I will show you an outline of the branches of Earth science according to earthhow.com. Studying our planet is such a vast topic because of all the branches of Earth science. Earth science involves how the natural world interacts with its surroundings. Because in order to define Earth science and its interconnectedness, we need a complete list of Earth science branches that encapsulates the topic in full. Now let's start. Astronomy is the study of celestial objects and phenomena. It is the all-encompassing term that studies everything beyond Earth's atmosphere. It applies the concepts from physics, biology and geology to explain their origin and evolution. There are four sub-parts of astronomy. Astrophysics. Astrometry. Astrogeology. And astrobiology. Astrophysics applies the laws of physics to galaxies, stars, celestial bodies and the universe as a whole. For example, astrophysics examines the evolution and classification of galaxies, general relativity and the expanding universe. It consists of the following sciences. Cosmology. It studies how the universe was created, evolves and its ultimate fate. Spectroscopy. It applies the principles of light to understand matter. Photometry. Gathers light within a range of wavelengths to determine the luminosity of astronomical objects. Astroseismology. Observes oscillations from stars to investigate their internal structure and composition. Helioseismology. Examines the interior structure, composition and dynamics of our sun. Heliophysics. It studies how the sun's radiation affects its surroundings in space including, space weather. Astrometry on the other hand is concerned with how celestial bodies are positioned and move in space. It involves how planets form in the solar systems including their composition and dynamics in history and how many and where planets exist outside our solar system. Astrogeology also talks on how geology relates to celestial bodies like moons, asteroids, meteorites and comets. Astrobiology on one part consists on how life, including extraterrestrials, in the universe evolved, originated and what will be its fate. It also involves in the search for life outside Earth including the environments that could support it. Now, let's go to the branches of geology. Geology is the study and science of how Earth's landforms were created, have changed over time and how they will evolve. Whether it's fossils, magnetic fields or types of landforms, geology is concerned with reconstructing the past. We divide geology into five parts. Chronology. Topography. Natural resources. Tectonics. And rocks or sediments. Chronology tackles about time and history. It tells us how old rocks and geological events are dated using signatures inherent in rocks and how geologic sediments and rocks are used to infer past earthquakes. It also deals with how organisms evolve and their interactions in their environment by studying fossil records often found in rocks and analyzing layers of rocks and strata to measure geologic time. Tectonics, another branch of geology, tells us how Earth's crust evolves through time contributing to mountain building, old core continents and earthquakes or volcanoes. This field applies the underlying principles of plate tectonics to seismology, volcanoes, earthquakes and other geological events. And of course, we have also the natural resources that includes all of the fields of science that governs with the raw materials and resources that we are using for our technology and for us humans to survive. We have petrology, the study of rocks. Mineralogy, the study of minerals. Agronomy also that talks how the field of agriculture involves science such as crop production, biotechnology and soil science. We have also the fields of sediments and rocks. One part of it is sedimentology that tells us how sand, silt and clay are deposited and the processes that act on it that. Hydrogeology also analyzes how groundwater is transported and is distributed in the soil, rock and Earth's crust and glaciology that talks about glaciers. The last one tells us the topography of our Earth. It is how physical features, natural and artificial, are arranged on the landscape. We use topography in climate models, air and water flow, land formations, and to better understand past tectonic activity. Now let's go deep into our oceans, in the branches of oceanography. Oceanography deals with ocean chemistry, physics, geology, and biology. In the chemistry part, it mainly talks about the composition of our ocean waters and tells us how these chemical properties interact with our oceans. In the physics parts, it involves with the movements of the water and how water travels in relation to land. It also tells us how deep are our oceans and how ocean currents circulate around the globe. The biology part is where we understand how life in the oceans behave in their natural habitats. And lastly, the geology part talks about how our ocean landforms will evolve in due time. Now, let us move on to the branches of meteorology. Meteorology is the study of short and long-term weather climate patterns, including its physical processes and effects on the biosphere. It involves weather and climate, the processes and also the organisms that depend on it. Mainly, it tells us how climate has varied in the past and how climate change will affect the future, how atmosphere chemistry and physics relate to weather and climate patterns, how topographic relief influences local climate in the lower air layer, and how air circulates in the atmosphere and being transferred on land in order for organisms to survive. Lastly, we don't forget the aspect of biology and environmental science. These branches of biology tackles more about how life and living organisms are structured, distributed, originated, evolved, and functions. Biology works with time, disease, ecosystems, and even extraterrestrials. It also works in different scales, from individual atoms to the entire biosphere. It involves the fields of pathology, chronology, ecosystem, and botany. Pathology enhances our understanding with diseases and fungi. It also answers the question how living organisms are affected, treated, and diagnosed by poisonous substances. Chronology, again, talks about the aspects of time on which we understand how living things change over time and how life originated. Ecology also talks on how organisms relate to each other in their physical environment, including distribution and population dynamics. And lastly, we have botany that enables us to identify how plants are classified, grow, and are managed in nature. Alright, that sums up everything about the fields and branches of Earth science. I hope you've learned something on our discussion. I would like just to cite Earth How for the comprehensive outline. You can find more resources about Earth science in their website. That's all for today. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel. See you on our next discussion.